Hi, my name is Benita and I am from Future-edgetherapy coaching and training. And it is a real pleasure to be able to speak to you today in conjunction with World Suicide Prevention Day. And I'm going to talk to you here about grief. I'm a trauma recovery therapist. I specialize in treating trauma, grief, anxiety, stress, PTSD, fears and phobias. And I've been doing this job for 4 years now. I have a lot of experience behind me. And I feel that grief is an underrated topic and one that isn't really discovered or isn't really discussed or talked about very often. But it's the one feeling and emotion that we will all experience at some time. And I have some firsthand experience of it. I think all of us have. But what does grief feel like? Grief feels and looks completely different to every single person who goes through or experiences it. You know, perhaps you are supporting someone who's going through grief at the moment. Now, what happens to the body and the mind when we go through grief? It literally makes our body and our mind ill. The grieving process is extremely lonely, it's isolating. And sometimes what happens is, as human beings, we are fairly weak in terms of moderating or regulating ourselves. And it can lead to what's called maladaptive coping strategies, like isolating ourselves, removing ourselves from relationships, food or substance abuse, just to try and get rid of that numb feeling or to numb the feeling of the intense loss that you feel. Now, at times, the emotional and the physical pain is just absolutely unbearable. And we can grieve before someone's passed. So if they're really poorly and you're expecting it, we can grieve during and we can grieve many, many months or years after. Not everybody grieves the same. And this is one thing that we must understand. And I think this is the point that most people don't understand. I work with a lot of people who've suffered grief. I have a grief program. It's in three parts. And grief recovery is not just a few sessions. It's not a few counseling sessions. It's not a few, you know, visits to see someone. It's a 6 to 12 month program. And people who are suffering grief need to be dealt with in a very specific way. Now, we need to help the person who's going through grief sort of readapt to their living circumstances. Perhaps they have got children. Perhaps they live on their own. Perhaps they need to return to work. And when we go through grief, our resiliency is absolutely and utterly tested to the maximum. Now, there are certain ways that grief makes us feel, and here's just a few. You know, we can suffer deep sadness, shock, guilt. Some suffer relief, but they feel guilty about it. Anger. We can feel numbness. And more severely, complete disassociation from the world. Many parents who've lost children or individuals who've lost a spouse or wife, a husband, a partner, can feel complete and utter disassociation from the world. So they forget. They don't care about what happens to them. They don't care about the people around them. They just operate in a state of numbness. And it has dire, dire consequences on your body. It completely depletes every ounce of strength you have, and it makes you extremely vulnerable to things like infection, to colds, to flus. It can even create and cause an increase in your blood pressure. It can disturb the heart muscle. So it's really, really serious. Now, most people who go through grief will suffer some physical reactions. So loss of appetite, upset tummy, tightness in the chest, crying, tense muscles, achy joints. They can have trouble relaxing. They have low energy, racing mind, nausea, headaches, dizziness. Gosh, you know, it's exhausting. The process. Insomnia, on the other hand, a complete loss of concentration. So they really can't cope with the basic structures of life, really. And they need intense support. Now, what's really interesting is that most people don't know that there are 5 stages to grief. And once you understand the 5 stages of grief, I make this very clear to all of the clients that I work with. that once you understand them, you know where you are. You can almost gauge where you are in the grief cycle or grief process. So the first stage is denial, then anger, bargaining, depression, and the last phase is acceptance. Now, I've worked with people who have been through grief or going through grief at stage 6 months, 1 year, 5 years on. I work with people who've been going through grief for 20 years because they've had such a massive impact on their life, and they've moved on like most of us do. We do actually do move on. Our brain does adjust. But, you know, how do we treat grief? How do we deal with grief? First of all, I don't think there's enough support from a corporate environment. And I know this firsthand, is that my wife suffered grief. Her father committed suicide. And this is why I'm so passionate about partaking on this day and giving information, is that her father committed suicide 14 years ago. She's a public servant. And she works for a national organization. She was treated awfully. She wasn't given the right support within the job. She wasn't given enough time off. There was complete insensitivity when she came back to work in terms of what area she would work in or who she would work with. Her role is a public service worker. She deals with the public and she deals with trauma on a daily basis and with individuals and people. And there was just a complete lack of understanding of why she couldn't come back and just perform the job that she did before. The circumstances, you know, suicide is hugely, hugely traumatic. And you don't understand, you can't process it. And she didn't actually have any help at all, apart from a few counseling sessions, which weren't very successful for her because it wasn't bereavement, it wasn't grief, a grief focus. So I want to make a note here and to let anybody who's watching this, if you work for an organization, you don't have a grief policy, then make one. If you need help with this, there are people out there, there are amazing people out there that can help with grief recovery and bereavement. And in fact, it's cheaper for a business to support an individual going through grief therapy or trauma recovery therapy than it is to have them off for 3 to 6 months, because that's inevitably what happens. My wife did have a period of time off, but she was forced to come back to work because the consequences at that point, bearing in mind this is 14 years ago, were really great. She had absolutely no support and ended up going off again, and I don't think has ever recovered from it. So grief can be recovered, you can recover from it, our brain does adapt, but we need to give it time, we need to give it what it needs, we need to feed the brain and feed the body, and we need to be looked after. So if you have any questions about grief recovery or for your organization, I offer a corporate therapy service where I am able to work with individuals either within the business or over or face-to-face or over Zoom. Or if you are someone wanting to know more information, please do not hesitate to contact me. So I'm Benita from Future Edge Therapy. You can contact me on benita@future-edgetherapy.co.uk or on 0797-001-235. Just don't do it alone because help is out there. And thank you very much.